Right, you'll have to excuse my compressor that's running, but I did promise this would be right back to the metal. I mean, we kind of were already there, but what I've done is I've finally blown everything out. I've obviously got all the black stuff off as well, which does come off. I just needed to use a little bit of a wire brush basically to get it off. You can see some scoring there, but basically that's it. Okay. Also, I've got the holes, you can see. Behind them, so you can see which holes go through. These little ones go right the way through to something, I don't know what it is. You might be able to see that one, I think. Oh yeah, I can't see where it is. There's a camera, there it is. Yeah, you might be able to see from the outside. There we go, see how that one goes all the way through. These ones in the middle section don't. But I think what it is with this is it's actually made in two pieces. Of course it must be, because it's got an internal cavity. And you can see that it's got, there's a kind of a, if I can get into focus, you can see there's a divider there, which had a little bit of paste sticking out. Sealant basically, probably could use, you know, instant gasket if you really wanted to crack it open. I don't, so this is as far as I'm going to go. But I wouldn't be surprised if you can't crack it open. I might actually in a future video, I don't know. But you can see that's basically it's a dividing line there. And then you've got your internal cavities there, of course, which you can just about see. This is visible for without dismantling it, basically. But that is now pretty much, there's no sediment or anything. This is pretty much how these guys would seem when they were being manufactured. Can't see it being much different, says you've missed a channel there. You know, I've got the screws still in, there's one missing because I lost one. This I think is a standard fit for a board, but the board isn't on it because they make them all the same, but this one doesn't have one. Yeah. So yeah, petrol seems to do the job, you know what I mean? Pretty much. But you have to work it because it doesn't break the actual scum down basically, but you have to use an implement basically to get it off and then work it right down to the metal. But you could use this as a heat sink now for another set of IGBTs. You know, maybe you could replace all of these, actually you could build the array back up again. You know, it's not beyond the realms of possibility to be able to just heat sink. I've still got the clamps, so you could clamp a bunch of them there, and then the bus bar, of course, is destroyed in this one because I cut it down the middle. But if there was some way of not actually not doing that, where you could actually take the bus bar off, if you could get the goo off, you can then probably desolder it all and possibly remove the bus bar without having to cut it in half like I did. Whether that'll work, I don't know. I mean, they've got to get it on somehow, so I would have thought that's probably how it was put on. And then you could remove the bus bar, and then that means it gives you access to the whole array, and then you can start replacing individual transistors, IGBTs, which are transistors, of course. So, I mean, these are, I've priced these up, and I think to rebuild the whole array of all three sets, not just this one, would be about £500, which actually isn't that bad. So you could rebuild one of these. If you didn't need to destroy it, you could actually rebuild it for £500. It'd be a lot of work, obviously, to get it down to this and then resoldering it all. And you would need to replace the goo. Why do they have goo on it? This is the question. Why do they actually put goo on it? So I'm thinking that the reason behind it is because you actually have quite high voltages and certainly high voltage spikes around here. And obviously wires have insulation on them, but if you have bare contacts, then you can, from a little hair or a spike or something, you can actually get an arc. And so they actually cover it in goo to prevent that, so it's all insulated. And that's the reason the goo is put on there, basically. It's to actually insulate it against high voltage arcing and stuff like that. So it is necessary in that sense, if you're going to use an array like this. You don't need it if you're actually using modules, because they've already got the goo inside them. So you can just use them without the goo, and that's actually probably the better way to do it. In fact, that's the modern way to do it now, is you buy the modules and then you mount those instead, and you don't need the goo in there. effectively what they're doing here is they're manufacturing one of those. You see, that's what they're actually doing. Now, you've got to bear in mind that when this was first produced, the Tesla Model S, you really couldn't get the modules. It really was just discrete. So fair play to them to actually make a solution out of it. No disgrace at all. But the world of manufacturing high power components has now moved on, and you don't need this anymore now, you know. So, you know, fair play for them for making the array. And they did it in the right way. They picked the right transistors, and they also used a gate resistor for each one, which then meant that the array would be balanced, instead of having different array elements kicking at different times because of the different gate levels. They use the resistors across the array, which is probably the most cost-effective way of doing it. Yeah, but you could rebuild it, but there's no point it's still cheaper to do it through an array. It is still cheaper because it would be about £500 to replace the whole array here with IGBTs. Whereas to do it with modules, those modules cost more, and so it's about £1,000 of modules. But using modules is actually a much better solution, of course. That's probably the reason why they cost them more, you know. But it is right down to the metal. There is no goo left on it. The surfaces are actually quite smooth and clean. I can't feel any stickiness now. So that's completely removed them, you know, and you can just wipe it off, basically. There's still probably a little bit of heatsink paste in there somewhere, which hasn't come off, but that's fine. So there it is, as promised, right down to the metal.